How are we doing again, John? Bruno, Ask Bruno, Fiber Instrument Sales, back in the office, firing up another video. I really think these are very important to do. Instead of having to answer a question a million times, we can just send you to a video, or you could find me this way. So let's go to another common question. Common question: why is my OTDR tracing my fiber and giving me the double lengths of my cable? I have a 500-meter cable, it's showing 1,000 meters. You know, I have a 2-mile cable, it's showing me 4. Simple answer to that, probably ghosting. So what is ghosting? The OTDR, optical time domain reflectometer, the R, works on reflections of light. Where do we get our biggest reflections? When we have a UPC connector on the other side, the far end of our cable, obviously at some point we have an end connector of a cable we're testing. Whether we have pulse cables on or launch cables on either end, there's eventually an end connector. An open-ended UPC single mode connector or PC multi-mode connector, that is our, because we're not getting that mating of the two UPC connectors, because we have an open end, right? So we're not getting that curvature working with the other connector. We tend to, you know, negative 55 dB on a pair, mated pair of UPCs, we tend to see 14 to 18 as a reflection on the end. So that's going to be your highest reflection. So why is that an issue? Well, that reflection can be so large that when it comes back to that OTDR, obviously there's a connector in the OTDR itself, that can be so large that it can actually take another trip down and back. And unfortunately, we get ghosting. We get reporting of double the lengths. You'll also see duplicate events, right? So if I have a, let's say a 2,000 foot cable, right? And at 100 feet, I have a bend. Well, you're gonna see at 2,100 feet that same event. So we'll have duplicates, it's a double trace. Can be annoying, obviously. Can we ignore them? Sure, what can we do? We can say, ignore that. We'll just put our markers at the real end. We know the rest is false. I don't like to do that. I don't like to have to explain all this to an end customer who we're certifying or testing for. So one of the answers, little tricks that I like to tell all my customers, and they're usually pretty grateful, is really something that FIS tends to call them black hole connectors. The industry calls them terminating connectors. So either term will work. And basically what a terminating connector is wherever that connector is on the far end, let's put a mating sieve or a bulkhead, and we're gonna plug one of these terminating connectors. And think of it as terminating resistors for open coax ports, right? Same thing. We don't wanna leave it open to the air when we test it. So we're gonna actually do that UPC to UPC connection right at the end of the cable. It's not gonna lengthen the cable, but what it does is, it's going to dampen down the reflections. It's going to get it back to that 50-55 area for a regular UPC. Remember, everything's got to be clean or it's out the window. But when we use that terminating connector, and again, it looks like just a connector with a boot. There's a little voodoo in there, smashed fibers, gels. But for around $5, $6, we can dampen that signal at the end. Now we've reduced that far end reflection so that as it comes back to that head end connector at the OTDR, it won't have enough power to go down and back. Ghost is gone. What, for $6, we eliminated the ghosting in all of our tests. Let's just put it on our far end launch cable. Problem solved. Hope this helps. Hope you can use it in your everyday testing. And I hope to see you guys somewhere on the road. Thanks again.